Okay, in this problem, there really are two good solutions to this problem. If you're going to have three solutions to a system of equations, you got to think about what that means, particularly given the x squared equals y squared part of the system. What I noticed when I looked at that was the only way you can have three solutions is if 0, 0 was one of your solutions. Because if, you know, 1, 1 was one of your solutions, and 1, negative 1 would have to be a solution. And, you know, you have these pairs of solutions that happen. So every pair, because of the y squared and the other one, and so every pair is going to create 2. And so the only one that you can have 2 is if you have a 0, 0. So that's one way to look at it. Another way to look at it that's a little bit cleaner is to look at it graphically. And so if we graph this, and I'm going to make this a pretty wide graph. So you've got to graph the x squared equals y squared first. And x squared equals y squared seems like maybe a little bit of a complicated graph until you start testing points. And what you're going to find out is x squared equals y squared is just the combination of the two graphs, x equals y and x equals negative y. And so it's just two straight lines that intersect each other at the point 0, 0, and are just essentially 90 degree rotations of each other. So the other one, if you look at, takes the classic example of being a circle. And it's got two specific qualities we know, and that is it's got a radius of 1 and a y coordinate that's 0. So the center here is going to be along the x-axis, and you need to find a point with a radius 1, you need to find a point where you're going to have three solutions. There really are three options. The first option is a circle that is going to intersect all three or all four parts of your x, you know, something that maybe looks like this. And if you have that, you're going to have four solutions. Another example would be one that maybe is going to intersect this graph, the right side here, more than once, but it's still going to result in four solutions. Or you could possibly have one that's going to be tangent, but if you have one that's tangent, that's just going to be two solutions because it's going to be the same distance away from that x-axis. So the only way to have three solutions is if one of your points is 0, 0, because if you got one point that's 0, 0, then it's going to look like this. And that 0, 0 point gives you this circle that intersects it right here at 0, 0, and then at these two points. We don't even need to know what those two points are, we just know it has two solutions. And the only way to get a circle that intersects at those three points is for it to be centered at 1, 0. And so A has to equal 1, or A could equal negative 1 because of it being on the other side. So the solutions are 1 and negative 1, and if you add those two together, that will give you 0.